Well, it's me again, and I'm back at the Dinky Trail. I'm going to go get some measurements. Hopefully today I can get enough information that I can probably find out what gauge this was, if it's something I can find out. But anyhow, that's what I'm doing. I'm not going to keep you turned on the whole time, otherwise this would be like a 3-hour video. So I'll bring you back anytime something cool happens. So talk to you later and stay tuned. Well, I don't want to hold out on you, so here's a few of the things I found since I've been digging this little spot. I've only been moving a couple feet, you know, around me. Found this neat steel plate thing. Or not steel, it's probably cast, but you can see it was like broken off, you know, bent over and broken. It's probably why it was discarded. Not sure what this is, but it looks like that was a rivet to whatever it was holding together. Here's a nice square, I think it's a square nail. When I get home and get the cleaning, if I find any threads, then I'd say it was a bolt, but I think it's a nail. And this one, I'm just pretty darn sure it's a square nail, just the way it is. And then this thing, which I don't know what, maybe the edge of a bucket. Now you can see it has some rivets. It would have been a heavy duty bucket, so that's interesting. And then this conglomeration of stuff here, again, not sure. Looks like there might be some metal pieces that are kind of congealed together with rock. And then some sort of head, I'm not sure if it's a spike or big old round nail, because the shank doesn't look as big as what the head does. I think there's concretion on that too. So I'm going to continue on. I'm not getting very far because I'm just finding stuff left and right, and this is wonderful. I'd really be able to put together a history of this area. Couldn't be more happy with that. So I'll talk to you later. Don't go away, more to come. Well, I gotta tell you, I'm wasted. And I've been digging so much iron back here. Just found a nice lead that looks like a big compressed musket ball. I'll have to look at it more later. It's been muddy and wet. I mean, I am just a mud ball. You can see my equipment. I mean, thank God for waders. I'm going up here right now to the Dinky track that's exposed. I showed you this once before. And what I want to do is take measurements of it. So if I have the measurements of the track, I can maybe tell where the what the gauge is. It might help me in figuring out the gauge. So I'm just gonna like maybe push it down here like this. Maybe it'll be on there while I take some measurements. Yeah, I think it will. Here's a nice piece of iron ore, looks like. Look at that. Just saw that laying there. How about that? Well, anyhow, I clean my glasses off a little bit. They're so full of mud and everything, I can't even see out of them. That's a little better. Okay, I gotta get my... I'm back. Really need to get a tripod someday. Just one more thing to carry. So, what I want to do is write down the dimensions. Just gonna draw a little picture. Wow. So, cross section would be something like this. That's where it come up. that. Up, flare out, into the rail. Alright, so it looks something like that. I really can't draw worth a darn. But, I gotta say, from top to bottom, oh boy, that's only like 2 3/4, considering maybe a little bit of wear. So we'll say 2 3/4. And then across this part here is 2 and boy, it's not real consistent. It's 2 1/8. And then across the rail here, where the car wheels would go, is about, looking about 1 3/8. So that's only 1 3/8. And then these little notches, I'm not sure why they're cut in there. I got a dilemma. First of all, I'm going to measure these notches. So it looks like they're, let's see, let's say half inch in. Notches 1/2. And then I'll bet it's going to be, oh, it's about 3/4. 3/4. Okay, 1/2 in, 3/4 long. Okay, let me double check that over here. Yeah, 3/4. By 1/2, yeah. And you can see that notch, what I'm talking about here. Okay, so that's the rail. Now, what I want to do when I go down is find the tie that has the two spikes in it, so I can measure end to end and see what the width apart would have been. Here's my dilemma. Coming up, another section of the little ore hole areas where they were digging, I found another little stream, and I think I mentioned it on one of my trips here. I found some different kind of spikes. They are the most adorable little railroad spikes you've ever seen. I found 2 of them. I'll show them to you tonight when I lay everything out. So it'll be in this video, just not right now. So the dilemma is, do those spikes, were they used with this rail right here? Or was there a different kind of rail? Or did the little spikes get used with this rail and the bigger spikes and ties, you know, have another type of rail? I just don't know. It's kind of like the plot thickens back here. Definitely the little cute spikes were for different size hold, you know, it didn't need as much force. I'm really sorry, I'm really tired. What I can do though is these notches that I right here that I was measuring, I can measure those with one of the bigger spikes and one of the smaller spikes and just see if that has any relevance to it all. It might give me a clue to move forward on it. Or maybe I'm going to find something that gives me an idea. So as I said, I found a lot of stuff, and I'll show it to you later. I'm not going to keep the camera on, mainly because I'm getting too tired. That makes sense. So I'll talk to you later. Thanks a lot. Bye. Well, I'm back in my truck. I gotta tell you, that's a hell of a hike. I carried a lot of stuff around with me today, a lot of digging and climbing. So that's it for today. I sort of had to give out. I hiked back down through the stream trying to find the tie. It had the spikes embedded in them so I could measure to try to figure out the gauge. I couldn't find it. I know it's still there. The water's up right now. We had some rain here, so it's running high, and I just can't see it. I was too tired to keep bending over looking for it and rooting. So I'll film my finds later at night when I get home, maybe after a nap. But anyhow, before this video is done, I'll have my stuff laid out and show you. Got quite a lot today. Talk to you later, and stick around for the end part. Thanks. Bye. Hello. I'm at home. Yesterday was the day I went to the third trip to the Dinky Rail. I was too tired last night to sort things out and do any filming, but here I am. It's this afternoon, the next day, and I'm going to put together a little finishing film. Now, this won't end the Dinky Rail, because I have a feeling I can go back there many, many times, and I will, until I can sort of put things together. I'd love to find some personal artifacts, maybe, of the people who work back there. Coins, anything like that to add to the collection here. And probably what I'll do is, once I get everything put together, I will donate this whole collection to the State Forest area. I'm sure they have some sort of little museum or welcome center type thing, and they may be interested in this. Maybe not. But at any rate, I'm really having a lot of fun trying to put together the whole concept of the area. So I'm going to show you some of the things I found. And as I said, this is going to be a work in progress. To start with, I found an old trap, hunting trap, and I'm not really familiar with this kind. It has some sort of springs in it. I'm more familiar with the kind that has like a bale that goes over and, is part of the spring itself. So I'm sure I can find a name for it. I just haven't looked it up yet. In fact, I had forgotten I found it until I laid everything out here. It's pretty old, and this would have been back in that stream section. So how old, I don't know. It's kind of a good indication that people have been using traps back in this, wet area longer than I would have thought. So, anyhow, let's move on. I have just a piece of flat iron here. You can tell it's been ripped off. I think I might have filmed this being pulled out. I'm not sure. Another notch over here. And then another heavy piece of iron has some various holes in it, you can see. And this one looks like it was very roughly cut out. It does have a lot of concretion type stuff on it and rust. But notice the little holes right here, just little dimple holes. That struck me as odd. I'll have to clean this up a little bit and just investigate a little more. Because there's definitely something that's punched into it. And then some just various, little pieces of steel and iron or whatever. This also, just I'm not sure if it's a piece with a lot of concretion on it and a small piece or a big piece. We'll see. I'll clean that up a little bit. And this is a bolt head. There's probably a bunch of this back there. There's some things I pulled out that are just too big to drag around in this trip because I had this other stuff. I'll be going back and probably some of it I'll bring. There's some things underground that are just really big. So it's going to take a little time to sort this whole thing out. This is a square nail that's, you know, the head has a lot of concretion on it. And you can tell it's square. Then I have a bunch of nails here. And it looked like some of these were dropped. I don't think they were ever used. I found them sort of like in a little pile. Some I didn't. Some I found, you know, were probably used for something and the wood is rotted away. So interesting. It looks like they're definitely square in nature, and it looks like they have some of them has the rose head to it, but I'm not sure if it's rust. I need to clean them up a little bit more. This one, for instance, does not look like a square nail. It looks more like a little bit later nail. It's certainly not a wire nail. And then this piece of twisted wire type stuff that, you know, could have been anything. This big thing, I'm sure, is some sort of bolt, and it has something attached here. I'm not sure what it is. It'll be interesting to try to figure out what that is. And then, of course, at the end, it has something too. I'm sure a lot of this is concretion on there, and I'll be able to get some of it off, but not going to go too far. This piece is interesting. It's just, I kept getting a signal, and I'm working and pulling around and digging holes, and it ended up the signal I was getting was right in the wood. At the time, this was packed with mud, but right here, let me get a nail, you can see in here, this is a square nail right in there, and it's just a part of it. Why? And it's not through to here. It's not through the other side. It just goes in. Who knows what it was? I'm not sure. But it's interesting it's into the wood there. Which kind of shows that this type of nail was most likely used back there. As I said, some are dropped, and it looks like some were used. Now to the interesting part. These are two little spikes I found. And this one has a lot of stuff on it, and I didn't do anything to clean it off yet. This one was a little bit cleaner. So I did scrape just a little bit and then sort of gently wire brushed it. I didn't do a lot. But you can see the tiny head compared to where the concretion one is. So maybe I'll clean that up a little bit. But I want to talk about the spikes a second. These are significantly smaller than the spike that I found in the larger stream. This is the ones I found yesterday in a smaller stream area. In fact, it's a section of stream that probably doesn't have water in it all summer. It probably dries up. This is the one that I found that was in the area that's always a stream. And this one, you know, because you can see I've pulled it out and then I put it through the electrolysis tank, so it really opened it up. But you can see, and I think I filmed this before, how the head of it really shows that it's been pounded over. I'm hoping a light's strong enough here that you can actually see the flow of the metal around. So these are a little harder to tell because they haven't broken down to that stage. Now I'm going to show you these again. These are the two different sizes of spikes that I found back in the Dinky Rail area. The bigger stream, the smaller stream. Does that mean that there were smaller tracks? And does it mean that, you know, different size carts or whatever, you know, different gauge of rail? Now, I'm going to show you this. This is a modern train spike. And I'll put the little one in between so you can really see the size difference. Big difference in size and shape, the whole thing. This one has like that, I think there's a term for it, but right underneath the head where it sticks out, there's a name for that little like tooth thing. And of course these are not having that. And not only that, the little dinky ones are more of a really dinky ones are more of a square head than a rounded head. And definitely the other size I saw like this that are still in the ties are more of a roundish head or an oval head, where these are more square. So anyhow, I'm going to have to go back and do some more searching to try to put it together. Now, I did find that rail, and you can see in the video prior to this segment, I was measuring the notch. Now, I'm wondering if maybe those rails were meant to accept this kind of spike, and since these heads are smaller and wouldn't offer as much support, did they maybe cut the notches out to be able to use the smaller spike? It's just kind of weird that there's two totally different sizes back there. And I don't know anyone at this point I can really question on this. So I just have to keep investigating on the internet and personally back at the Dinky Rail site. So that's where I'm at. That's, as I said, the third trip back. And there's a lot of stuff I didn't bring out. And just tons of stuff under there because it is Iron Haven. Every place I go, I'm getting signals almost. So I'll keep you updated as more things happen. And I'm going to post this one as Dinky Rail Visit Number 3 or something like that, so we can start differentiating. Thanks for watching. I hope this isn't getting boring for you. I'm pretty sure I'm going to find some very interesting things back there, given time. So, again, thanks for watching. Please give me a thumbs up, and if you haven't subscribed, it really helps me out if you do. Talk to you later.